Kilkelly, Ireland, 1860, my dear and loving son John. Our good friend, the schoolmaster Pat McNamara, is so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England. The house is empty and sad. The crop of potatoes is sorely infected, a third to a half of them bad. Your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to be married in June. Your mother says not to work on the railroad and be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1870, my dear and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your four children. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble. I think he never will learn. Because of the dampness, there's no turf to speak of, and now we have nothing to burn. Bridget is happy you named a child for her, although she has six of her own. You say you found work, but you don't say what kind or when you'll be coming home. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1880, dear John and Michael, my sons. I'm sorry to give you this very bad news. Your dear old mother is gone. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly. Your brothers and Bridget were there. You don't have to worry. She died very quickly. Remember her in your prayers. But it's good to hear that Michael's returning. With money he's sure to buy land. The crop is still poor and the people are selling any price that they can. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1890, my dear and loving son John. I suppose I must be close on to 80. It's 30 years since you've gone. But because of all of the money you sent me, I'm still living out on my own. Michael has built himself a fine house, and Bridget's daughters are grown. Thank you for sending your family picture. They are lovely young women and men. And you say you might even get home for a visit. What joy to see you again. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1892, dear brother John. I'm sorry I didn't write sooner to tell you. The father passed on. He was living with Bridget. She said he was happy and cheerful down to the end. Ach, you should have seen him play with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, our friend. We buried him alongside a mother down at the Kilkelly churchyard. He was a strong and determined old man, considering his life was so hard. And it's funny, but he kept on talking about you. He called for you at the end. Oh John, why don't you come home for a visit? We would all love to see you again. We would all love to see you again.